Do you guys remember Fable? It was a pretty big Microsoft flagship series for a long time, and the creators went on record to say what went wrong with it. If you've never seen it or played it, I'm gonna have background footage while I talk about the story, but you really should play Fable 1 or Fable Anniversary or even Fable 2. So let's begin. Peter Molyneux recently discussed his regrets regarding the Fable series, citing large time jumps between each game. Not the game releases, he's talking about in-game world. He quoted it as being a big mistake. And what he was talking about was that he went through the worlds too quickly. So he said originally they were about 500 years apart, and in retrospect, he thinks it should have been a 50-year time jump instead. Quote, it meant that the world jumped. The same with Fable 2 to Fable 3. Again, the world jumped into a more kind of inspired Victorian times. I love the fact that Bowerstone had grown into a more of an industrial thing, but we moved too far forward and meant that we ran out of time. You know, where do you go next? Fable in space? That didn't really fit. Okay, so I'm about to lose my mind because Fable was probably one of my favorite series of all time. I think it's probably in my top 10 games of all time. The original Fable, the remastered anniversary edition is really good, man. And I'm very happy that it came out because I don't think we're ever going to get another Fable ever again. Basically, what I think the issue was not the time period. You're making up a story. You don't go from Victorian times to Fable in space. And I get the fact that you don't want to take something that's medieval or Victorian and instantly jump it into the 21st century where we have automatic machine guns and tanks. That wouldn't really fit either. But what if you just extended out the chapters? What if you just created a side story? What happened to the main protagonist after he killed Jack of Blades? What happened if he had put that mask on and became Jack of Blades? I wanted to play through scenarios like that. Why couldn't you have continued that? Now, my biggest complaint, my number one chief complaint, is that not only were there no more bosses, not really bosses, in the second one forward, but there was also the lack of armor, resources, and stuff like that. You know, I'm supposed to be playing this character who was either a great wizard, an assassin, a thief, or a warrior, a knight of sorts in the original game, and then I need to conform down even further from that into Fable 2, and then in Fable 3, it's like, well, you really don't have too much of a choice now, do you, in the type of weaponry you can use, and the type of spells you can cast now. You can't wear armor and look like a knight. You can't put on certain types of clothing that would just alter your class, pretty much. And when that transition came, and the lack of boss fights, it kind of stopped the build-up. It would be like if you took out the boss fights from any RPG and you just let the game go and had one final boss that didn't even matter. It was a massive letdown. I think Fable 2 was one of the biggest letdowns in the world. You had this massive buildup. Yeah, it didn't have bosses, and yeah, you couldn't really be a knight anymore or anything like that. Okay, all right, cool. But it still had the Fable 1 spirit in it. And then at the end, it's just like, well, whether or not you chose to kill the final boss, it didn't matter because he would die anyways. It's like you didn't even have to do anything. You didn't even have to show up, really. I don't know. That's how I personally feel about it. I think if they had continued the medieval theme and would have expanded on the things that they had going for them, like having a wife, like having a family. Look, you could say, okay, you know, they made outlandish claims that never came true. I get that. Okay, cool. But what they did have was pretty cool. You got scars on your body from encounters that lasted with you till the end of the game. You know, you could have a wife, a kid, in multiple places. It was a pretty cool scenario to be either a hero or a villain anywhere you went. And I thought that was really, really awesome for them to do. And unfortunately, they really screwed the franchise up. From Fable 2 on, Fable 3 was a mess. A lot of people liked it, but it wasn't as good. It wasn't as tight. It had a weird menu system. And then they had other spinoffs, Fable Connect, Fable Heroes, which wasn't horrible, but I mean, it's just not the game you wanted to play. No Fable 4, ladies and gentlemen, and I'm sorry to have to say that. You guys have yourselves a great day. Let me know what you think. Killed Fable in the comment section below if you have played it. If you have not played it, let me know if you would want to play it from seeing the background footage. I've been your host, Protomario. I'm signing out. As always, good gaming, and God bless. Thanks for watching.